zooming all the way from, well, not zooming, but you know, zooming all the way from Singapore. So today, what I was trying to think, what can I share with you guys? Because, you know, this goes out to the whole world and there's so many amazing dancers nowadays. I try to really think, what can I add? What can I help? What can I contribute? So what I thought I'll do today is actually a class to be like an overview of some jazz steps, which most of you already all know anyway, but I just thought I'll talk it through and discuss some observations and some learnings and some personal revelations which I've had even this past few months as I took classes with so many amazing teachers from around the world. And you know, I try to reflect and try to think, what makes this jazz step? Of course, I'm not any expert of any sort. For that, you have to look at the old videos. I like keep punching. I really think that is great because you see so many dancers doing the Big Apple and all the amazing jazz steps, and they all are doing the same step, but they all express it in their own way. So I feel that that's a great lesson in itself, to be watching one dancer for the whole thing, and then you watch, play it again and watch another dancer throughout the whole thing, and try not to be distracted by the glorious multi-movement and energy of all this ensemble, but you know, learn from each one of the dancers and then put it into yourself and go crazy. But yeah, so and like watching, if you can see any videos of Frankie doing the Shim Sham, that also is an amazing lesson in itself, because you know, really, they knew what they're doing when they sang that song. It ain't what you do, it's the way that you do it. And all the Shim Sham steps that we might have done 100 times, we can still look at Frankie doing it and like try to see what is it that makes it nice step, and beyond just it's the right foot, the left foot, the right foot, the left foot, and such like that. Okay, so as I said, it's not a choreography that I'm talking to, but I'm going to talk to certain jazz steps and talk about how I approach them now as I teach new people, as I work with people that have been dancing for a while, and what do I look for when I try to create within that jazz step. Okay, so we're going to start with the boogie back, and that's, you know, the first thing I usually teach. If I'm teaching a class of absolute beginners, whether it's Lindy Hop or jazz, I will start with a boogie back, because I think that's such a foundational idea of the movement and of getting into the groove of swing. Because as you all know, the boogie back is, well, in its technical thing, is a clap on the eight, and maybe there's a kick, and there's an and one, right? So you're kind of landing or jumping on the one, eight and one. Okay, technical, go away. Now we listen to the music, and the music's going gang, 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 gang. And you're clapping and getting so into the music that you're gonna add your body clapping to it or responding to the clap. So it's gunga, 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 gunga. And as you get into the music, you will stop, hopefully stop counting, and really just be part of the band, part of the music, and wanting to play with the music. Let's try that. I like to use C Jam Blues, and this one is the Lincoln Center Jazz Orchestra playing it. I feel that all swing music has a great rhythm section going, right? But somehow this recording helps bring it out very clearly, and hopefully even for beginners, they get what the feeling of the rhythm. And And you know, it's one note, the C, that so you're not worried too much about melody, but you can get into the groove. Okay, so let's go. So we're just listening. Okay, and clap along like you are at a concert. Nice grooving, the knees totally have to be soft. So another little thing I'd like to talk about and work on is to remind people that most movement or motion comes from your sensor. You want it to come from your sensor. So, yes, unfortunately, as bad teachers will tell you, it's your right foot, it's your left foot, or it's your right foot step, it's your left foot step. Yes? So, if you're learning it by your feet, it goes like that. Or even like a boogie walk, which is the next step I want to talk about. So the boogie walk, right foot, step, A, two, okay? And all the hands might come in. Thus, maybe. That is kind of like a boogie walk. It's a nice start. But let's take it back a bit. And remember, boogie walk is like a strut. And when you strut, this don't look very strutting, right? Okay, what will help you is that remember the movement all comes from your center. So, like if you ever see models on the catwalk, they're not walking right, left like this. They're walking with the whole leg. Yeah? And that sway comes because they're using their whole leg to rise the foot. They probably have to do that because they're wearing those strange shoes. But they're raising their hips to make the walk. So like in the boogie walk, for example, let's try this. That you want to think it's not the foot, it's the hip and the core that is making the isolation and giving you that boogie boogie walk. Okay? So we can practice it by just actually taking the step and not moving the foot. Okay, so it's not about the foot making circles, but it's about the hip. Okay, so again, you're gonna step your foot here, and you're gonna think of your hip bone, which is this thing that I always hit on tables as I go by. Hip bone is gonna make a circle and come back. So around and come back. Make sure it comes back, okay? If you keep going like this, you're gonna end up walking like such. But you wanna come back around here. And it's in one count. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? So you're just gonna step on 8 and 1. And you have and 1. 1.5 counts to get around. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, as you do that, and get your control of that, hold your upper body so that it's strong. Think that it's strong, not that it's stiff, but it's strong. Yeah, so you can just block them here or here, but it's strong so that they are not moving, and that helps you to give the lower part isolation. And don't forget the ends. 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes, all that comes in there. Okay? So that's boogie walks. Now, this is currently my favorite step. It's the fall of the logs. Okay. So fall of the logs. Again, you might have learned it that right foot, step, step, left foot, step, step, step. Which is good. You know, sometimes we need to explain to our feet what they need to do, you know, with this strange dance. But now that our feet kind of know what to do, let's talk to the body and tell the body that you're gonna dance too. Don't leave it to the feet. Alright?
either one. Okay? So you're hopping on your starting leg, which could be your left, and your right leg, don't think of a kick, don't think of a race, don't. It's not about you. Okay? It's about you. It's about you. So you want to think, hop. And kind of naturally, if you're hopping on one leg, you want to make this hop, the other leg, something will happen. Yes? Either one. So what's that? And then you're going to have three nice steady steps. Three nice steady groups, okay? And one, two, three, five, six, seven. And one, two, three. And then you repeat it on the reverse. You're going to hop on your right, four. Because that's the upbeat onto the five, six, seven. So if you count in fours, it'll be one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. So what I don't want you to do is think at the beginning of eight and four, whatever numbers are, of this step, is the step. That is not the essence of the step. No, it's the beginning of the step. And yes, follow the lock has many hand variations, many feet variations, but that's smoke and mirrors. That's not what the step is about. Yes? So get that feeling and that rhythm, and then you can add whatever arms shapes you want. Another little tip I found useful is not to think to travel too much. It's called fall off the log. The log ain't that big. Okay, the log is kind of like here at the most. Or if you want to do this kind of variation. Yeah? But that little rolling feeling of falling off the log, falling off, it means that the step kind of happens here because you are trying to keep your balance. You're trying to keep your balance on the bottom. I'm going to play some music and you can watch that. Okay, so remember that eight is a preparation step for the one. And don't forget your hands. Watch my hands. Are we done yet? No. Okay, I've got another step that I want to talk about is Susie Q's. Yes, one of the more challenging steps, and there are so many versions floating around, and of course, pick your battle, pick how you want to do it. Again, these are just some ideas and thoughts that I've picked up along my dad's journey. So it's again quite acknowledged that it begins on the 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and you can reverse it. Yes? Okay. So one thing that helped to make it close to what I see on the videos is that the front foot is always flat. You want to think the front foot flat and the back foot up. And this is something that Ryan Francois has drilled into me, and like it or not, I can't unsee it. I can't not say this is how it has to be done. Okay? So, eight, one, two. So I would say the front foot is flat, the back foot is up. And as you step, yeah, you want to keep your knees soft and don't forget the hands. Okay? So we're going to the back. Eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Don't cross because it will get tied up. I would just think of like together, open together. the step really fun. I've seen this guy coming in very recently, seems to be a third. But to play it safe, clap on the eight, hold it there, and do the classic better up thing. I've seen sideways, I've seen forward, I've seen this, I've seen this, I've seen running. Thank you, Miss Susie Q, for gifting us this step. Of course, this step is named after a chorus girl, Susie Q, who used this step, if I'm not wrong, as her exit off the stage. Thank you, Susie Q. And now, a step which is called the Applejack. This one is a pretty tricky one to talk and teach about and find in your body. So, have fun. Okay. So the Applejack ain't the loompa pa 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 pa. So that's the Applejack. It usually starts with the 8-ball change. So we're gonna go 8 and 1. And on the 1, your left foot, you know, it's a kick, step 1. Have your left foot kind of turned in, and on whatever the next count is, turn it out and step with your right. And then okay. And there go talking left, right, bang, bang, bang. Okay. So this is the revised version of how to think it through. A and one. As it comes down, you're gonna raise up here from the hip and step it down. And as you pick it out, you're gonna pick up from the hip and step it down. At the same time, your shoulders do not follow the hips. Shoulders are going to fight and twist in the opposite direction, so you can save the shoulders from the keep facing front. Okay, and that's why it's helpful to have your hands in a strong, stable position here. Okay, and as you step, step, step. Okay, so you want to think of the hip driving the twist. So as you twist out, it's the hip, and I'm going to put my hand on the hip so you can see as I go. Well, thank you for listening to me and hearing my thoughts on all these steps. If you have questions or disagreements or arguments or clarifications that you want to make with me, send me a message. You can find me on Facebook or ask Paulette.
Thank you very much. I hope you keep dancing.